Hi everyone, welcome back to Sashay Away with Barry. It has been a while since I've posted a real video, and this isn't really gonna be one either, but I am back. I went to Sasha Velour's nightgown show in Brooklyn tonight at National Sawdust, and it was amazing. It was so good. Ryan and I had a lovely, lovely time. We stood upstairs in the balcony, and I took a lot of videos. I missed one, so I'm sorry, Scarlet Envy, but I did not get your video. I thought I was recording and it didn't record at all. And then I started recording after it and recorded the ceiling. So I'm dumb. Sorry, Scarlet Envy, but I missed yours. But in order of what you're going to see is it starts off with Sasha Velour. She always opens the show. Then it was Scarlet Envy, who I missed. Chris of Her, who I don't think I've seen. I probably saw at Bushwick, but I didn't remember her. And it is an amazing, amazing performance. I am now a fan and will be stalking her on Instagram, find all the good things that she does. She's an amazing artist, costume person, and this was a great performance. Again, that's Chris of Her. Yeah, look it up. Then was followed by one of my favorite queens, Untitled Queen, who is just an amazing artist, and it is just what she does on stage is pure art. It's just performance after performance after performance. I love every single one. So I'm always happy to see her, and she is a regular at Nightgown, so I get to see her every time I go. Following her was another regular at Nightgowns, and that is Neon Calypso from Boston. She is a fierce queen. She's a little messy. But damn, what a performer. Someday I hope that she is on RuPaul's Drag Race. It will do worlds of wonder for her, and she will be fantastic. She's so good. Her energy on stage is fantastic. And I just love watching her, and I get excited every time I get to see her. After that is Miss Malice, who is a bio queen. I don't know what the real word that they're using. I know people don't like to be called bio queens, but she's a bio queen. She's a woman that does drag, and she's amazing at it. And she performed with Switch and Play, who I also love. That is Kay James and Vigor Mortis. They are drag kings, and they are fantastic as well. So you get a little trio there. After that is the one and only Vander Von Odd from Dragula Season 1, the winner. She's an artist as well, spectacular. She looks great on stage, and it is a great performance. I think it was Kate Bush that she does too, and it is really, really good. After that is the one and only Lady Quesadilla, and her little house of gem, and it is so exciting to see her. I'm happy to call her my friend. I love that she is how now become part of this House of Velour Nightgowns family. This is, I think, her third time that she has been a part of it. And so I was excited to see her. She does a nice little performance with her little house kids and enjoy. After that is Sasha Colby. She is a trans drag queen. I don't know if she's considered a trans drag queen, trans performer, whatever. Girl lights up the stage. She is hot, hot, hot. I call her a cross between Britney Spears and Miss Beyonce. If they had a love child, it would be Sasha Colby. She's stunning. And damn, what a good performer she is. She's from Hawaii, and now she is part of the Nightgowns family. I think she's going on tour with them as well, and it is just fantastic to watch her every time she performs. After that is a Brooklyn queen, all the way from Texas, Miss Horachada. She is one of the founders of Bushwig, and I thank her for that because I love going to Bushwig. So this was fun to see her. She did a Selena number. Which is her specialty, and it is fantastic. Following that is another performance from the one and only Sasha Velour closing out the show, and then you get all the end credits and say goodbye, or you get to congratulate all the queens, not say goodbye, congratulate all the queens that performed. They all come out on stage for one final bow, and the show is over. So I hope you enjoy it. I had a great time again. I look forward to it. They are doing another one on New Year's Eve, and Cross your fingers, I may be at it. We'll see. I have no New Year's Eve plans yet. So it could be. I did just order two new gowns that are on their way, so I'll have something to wear as well. So that is all for now. Enjoy the videos. I hope they all post. I've been having a lot of problems with YouTube lately. They keep blocking things because the music is copyrighted, so I kind of go through a few different postings of it once that happens, but hopefully everything will be kosher this time and it will all work out. We'll be back very soon because the Holisley episode is this week. Can you believe it? It is Holisley this Friday, and then next week we start All Stars 4. So we will be back in rotation. I had a good break from kind of doing this every week. Here I am, I'm back, I'm sitting on the bathroom floor, and we will be back with guests coming up very, very soon. I still haven't done a Meet the Queens for All Stars 4 yet, so maybe we'll do a combined Holisley recap All Stars 4 Meet the Queens next week after the show. Till then, take care, I love you all, goodbye.
Baby cried the day the circus came to town. She didn't like parades just passing by, so she painted on a smile and took up with some clown. While she danced without a net upon a wire, I know a lot about her, 'cause you see,
I'm not even a star, but I'll be a spooky themes thing, but the real horror story is getting up those stairs. But I made it. Hi, I'm Miss Malice. And this is a real Brooklyn show tonight. You know, we've got a lot of the Brooklyn icons in this cast. I'm so honored to be a part of it. And since we have such a Brooklyn show, I wanted to give you my kind of ode to one of my favorite places in Brooklyn, a true creepy New York landmark, Coney Island's Spookorama. Some of you know what it is, some of you are about to find out more about it than you ever needed to know. So, first things first, here's something that's true. Queers love spooky shit. Because spooky shit is really gay. Thank you. Witches, ghosts, vampires, the supernatural, they fuck shit up, okay? They unleash chaos, they threaten to disrupt cis heteropatriarchy, reason, rationality, these forces of control used to contain us. They represent our otherness, what's unspeakable, invisible. And their stories express the emotional core of so many of our experiences. Isolation, grief, fury, vengeance. And so we hold tight to those stories, I think, because they offer us that flicker of recognition. We see something of ourselves and what others fear, and we might find power there too, because there's fucking power in being terrifying. So in 1773, in response... Listen, I'm telling you, we are going there. Welcome to Queer Spooky School. Please turn your textbooks to page 48. It's happening. In 1773, in response to the rise of the Gothic novel, this woman writer, Anna Aken, tried to explain the appeal of spooky shit. That's how I'm summarizing it, anyway. And so she had this idea. The essay was called, first of all, On the Pleasure Derived from Objects of Terror. It's good, right? Yeah, sexy. Thank you for having the appropriate response. And so she had this idea that when you experience a thrill, something that makes you jump, something unexpected, it actually stretches your mind, jolts your imagination, and allows you to explore with rapture a whole new world of possibility suddenly laid open to your view. Now, I don't know if Dear Anna was a dyke like me, but I do know that that makes me think of that secret thrill, that surge of unnameable joy I felt every year as a kid around Halloween when it was time to pull out those cardboard boxes of decorations, the kitschy black cats with arched backs, the rubber bats to hang in the hallway. You know, time to transform the mundane every day into a world that suddenly felt full of potential for a queer kid like me. And it's that same sense of recognition and possibility I feel when I'm at Coney Island and I walk by this outlandish exterior of the Spookorama with like the skeleton playing the organ outside. And in 1955, when the Spookorama was first built, because it's that old, it was actually the longest ride at the entire Coney Island amusement park. It was 10 minutes long. 10 minutes. 10 minutes of winding pretzel track that passed under a simulated blood waterfall, took you through an outdoor courtyard and across two separate buildings filled with eerie figures and sensations. But here's the real reason why I'm obsessed with the Spookorama. This early version of the ride was dominated by imagery of monstrous femmes. Shapely demons and witches loomed over the cars, neatly embodying, of course, post-war America's utter horror of strong, assertive femininity. My favorite is a true spooky sister. I had to bring her with me tonight. Thank you so much, Zoe Ziegfeld. Cannot think of a more appropriate person to hold this. Do you see her? Can you see her? She's everything. She's part Bride of Frankenstein. She's part vampire. She's part film seductress. She's got the big red hair. She has these fangs. Oversized red lips parted by those fangs. She dares men to look at her and holds them in a gaze that promises their certain obliteration. Ooh, no laugh for that, all right? Brings me joy. So I have spent... Love you. Love you, Slash. I have spent hours poring over grainy archival photographs of these early figures and imagining myself on this version of the ride, smiling up at these badass, potent, queer forerunners as everyone else's screams ring out around me. So now you know a little bit about what I do in my spare time. But okay, so there are naysayers. There are folks who really hate this whole idea of queer identification with spooky shit. Like, oh, but isn't there always some guy with like a stake to put through the lesbian vampire's heart at the end? And okay, yes, fair, true. But we know better. We know how to read between the lines. We know that there's always a sequel. We know that there's always one more scream before the credits roll. We know that vampires are immortal, obviously. She's coming back. And the Spookorama still stands in the same place that it did 63 years ago. Each grinding twist of the track, ready to give us one more scare and help us see that glimpse of that world of possibility where we never have anything to fear. And so now, in the spirit of spookiness, queerness, and spectacle, let's hit it.
It could never be answered if it had to be asked. Vander Von Ahn! Buenas noches, everybody! My name is Lenny K. Sabdilla, darling, and get a load of this dress.
Yes!
What an honor to be here tonight. And Johnny, I know I am not gonna go on my 15-minute rant like I did at Bushwick, because I know that we are short on time, but give it up for my gorgeous, gorgeous friend, Sasha. You know, darling, that is what you do when you, like, not only have privilege, but when you're a fucking badass. When you are a superstar, you share the stage with all of your friends. I bow down to you, please. So, one of the lessons that I have learned in my journey of recovery, of living with HIV, of being unstably housed when I was working full time with a salary job, was that not only do I have to be kind and generous to those around me, that I needed to do that for myself. Darling, and that is fucking difficult. One of the really difficult lessons that I had to learn was that when I lost my job at an agency that I refused to name, but what I will say is that you should give all of your money to Callan Lord, you should give all of your money to GMHC, you should give all of your money to The Door, was that what was I gonna do to continue the relationship with the queer youth that I was mentoring, right? Because I lost my mentor, Jose Esteban Munoz, you know, and that relationship, you know, continues through his work, right? But, you know, and I can, you know, continue talking about that. So instead of talking about that, you know, I'm gonna perform about that, right? So without further ado, I present to you some of the members of the House of Jose Esteban Munoz, right? Of the House of Gem. First and foremost, all of the way from Jersey, we have Magic Call. Please give it up for Magic Call. Up next, all of the way from La Isla del Encanto, please give it up for Onima. Last and certainly not least, please give it up all the way from the fucking Bronx. Honey, please give it up for Constance.
I gave the greatest performance. No me queda más. Si tú regresas. veces que nunca pasó. Es el más dulce recuerdo de mi vida. Yo tenía una esperanza en el fondo de mi alma, que un día te quedaras tú conmigo.
Welcome.
actually a Hanukkah number and didn't know it. Happy Hanukkah, everyone. Okay. Oh yeah, let's move this giant cord. Thank you, Zoe, before we welcome all these incredible performers back up onto the stage. I'm gonna take 10 seconds to gather my breath. Oh my god, what an amazing show! See what I said about impractical costuming? Thank you, darling. Please welcome our fabulous guest tonight, Scarlet Envy! And the fabulous James Wilson on piano! Chris of Her! From the house of Switch and Play, Miss Malice, K. James, and Vigor Morales. Lady Quesadilla Rodriguez with Magic Call, Constance Bustier, and Onina. Horachana. And we gotta scooch, y'all. We have to scooch. There we go, beautiful. Beauty scooching. And let's welcome our regular cast, Sasha Colby. Neon Calypso. Vander Von Odd. And Untitled Queen. Give some love to the folks up in the booth that run this whole show. Especially my love, Tony Galore. Backstage we have Nancy the Girl, Gina Guerin, and Zoe Ziegfeld. And up on spot, one of the most important roles in a drag show, the lovely Miwa. Make some noise! This incredible lineup. This is what drag is all about. We've got more work to do to make sure this representation exists on every stage. This is what queerness fights for. We love you so much. Have a-